saying hello to your body. I invite you to start thinking about the spine, really taking your attention to your spine. And those are the ways in which you like to get your spine mobilized and stabilized for the journey ahead. Play it through the different regions of the spine, so just an easy turn of your head with as little tension as possible, relaxing the jaw, and then allowing yourself to turn through the ribs into the thoracic spine, and then what's available for your rotation in the lumbar pelvis. And then kind of in stillness, let's just bring hands to midline and close the eyes for a moment here. And breathing, feeling the breath going into spine as well, closing the eyes. And we'd like to ask you to identify some curiosity, some question, some aspect of the spine that you feel like you want to explore a little bit, and or some reason why you feel the spine is important in your life and in whatever practices that you study. So you're making a little sculpture with your hands that conveys as much information as possible about the architecture of this crazy shape. How can you express the openings, the poking out places, the arches, the ridges, the lovely. And then go back and create that sculpture with that much more specificity. Now you're going to do the same process with your whole body. So you need a little bit more space to move out from each other. A lot of space in between, a lot of open spaces. Right, travel, y'all. See it from many angles.
I want you to think about those processes a little bit and speculate what those might be about as we go to the next component. Five turns, you're okay. One more time, repetition. So the main solid part of your vertebra is called a vertebral body, good. The hole in it, the biggest hole, vertebral frame. When we stick those together, we'll be doing that a little bit later. You might hear Kate and I slip into a term called the vertebral canal. It moves from being just one hole to having a whole bunch of holes lined up in that vertebral canal when we articulate the entire column. So towards your back, or the dorsal part of the body, you'll find on each vertebra a spinous process. And if you've ever felt the bumps as you're feeling down the back of your neck, so not only are you the base, essentially, the bedrock of the spinal column, but what else are you anchoring?
The pelvis.
The pelvis, and what's attached to the pelvis?
The legs.
Yes, okay, so there's a lot going on. Yeah.
Notice how we're getting all these nice spinous processes aligned, right, down the back. That's one image that sometimes people use in aligning, say, allow the spinous processes to drop down. Word? Yeah, so definitely we got a clear sense of the lumbar curve. The thoracic curve actually is going to curve posteriorly, and then the anterior curve of the cervical spine comes back in, and the noggin sits right here.